not a qualified physician, and I don't want to give this injection. I am not a qualified physician, and I don't want to give this injection. Dorothy is begging for trouble, she insists I should give her this needle. But darling, one thing I want you know, don't blame me for where the needle go. I push it in, she pull it out, I push it back, she start to shout, Dr. Gage, it's terrible, I can't stand the size of your needle. She lie down in such a position, it was difficult to give this injection. She start holding on to the needle, making me so uncomfortable. I say, darling, can't you be steady? I'm going to have it done very shortly. She say, Dr. Kish, I am sorry, but the sight of the needle frightened me. I push it in, she pull it out, I push it back, she start to shout, Dr. Kish, it's terrible, I can't stand the size of your needle. She still wouldn't lie down quietly, constantly moving her body. So I slap her in the face with vexation, and I went on giving the injection. She screamed, Doctor, stop, I can't stand the pain, I don't think you inside the right vein. I said, it's your own fault, you won't be told, the needle must be sleeping the wrong hole. I push it in, she pull it out, I push it back, start to shout, Dr. Keach, it's terrible, I can't stand the size of your needle. I pull it from that hole and start again, I have the needle now in the right vein. The needle just gone in half an inch, the stupid young lady start to flinch. Suddenly she bawled, it is hurting, Doc, I can feel the penicillin going in. I said, you little fool, look what you do, you talk until the needle breaking you. I push it in, she pull it out, I push it back, she start to shout, Dr. Keach, it's terrible, I can't stand the size of your needle.